Very good morning, students. In today's session, I want to give a brief lecture on important concept electrochemical cell. First of all, the electrochemical cell is nothing but a device that converts the chemical energy into electrical energy or the electrical energy into chemical energy. So with the device called electrochemical cell. Most of the electrochemical cells are we known as galvanic cell or the voltaic cell, which can make use of these chemical reactions and generate electrical energy. First of all, come to the basic difference of galvanic cell and Daniell cell. The galvanic cell is an important electrochemical cell and it is named after Luigi Galvani, an Italian physicist. It is also called voltaic cell, of course, but after an Italian physicist, Alessandro Volta. A galvanic cell generally consists of two different metal rods that are called electrodes, and each electrode is immersed in a solution containing of its own ions, and these forms a half cell. Each half cell is connected by a salt bridge or separated by a porous membrane. So it is a device called galvanic cell. Now come to a Daniell cell. A Daniell cell was invented by another scientist, John Frederick Daniell. In the Daniell cell, copper and zinc electrodes are immersed in a solution of the respective copper sulfate and zinc sulfate solutions. These two half cells are connected through a salt bridge. So this is called Daniell cell. Only the basic difference of these two cells is the usage of or the taking of the metals, that is electrodes. Now come to the part of the galvanic cell. A galvanic cell should possess different parts. In this, first one is anode. Anode is an electrode, of course. Whenever oxidation occurs at this electrode is called anode. Likewise, cathode. Cathode is an electrode at which reduction process occurs. Salt bridge. Salt bridge that contains electrolyte solution, which are required to complete the circuit in the galvanic cell. Half cells. Half cell is nothing but a reduction and oxidation reactions are separated into two compartments. External circuit. It conducts the flow of electrons between the electrodes. And finally, load. A part of the circuit utilizes the electron to flow to perform its function. So these are the major parts of any galvanic cell: anode, cathode, salt bridge, half cells, external circuit, and load. Now come to the construction of the galvanic cell. So it is a brief construction of galvanic cell. Here this galvanic cell is obtained by the combination of two half cells. What do you mean by half cell? A half cell is nothing but when an electrode that is respectively immersed in its own ions of salt solution called a half cell. Here this galvanic cell is constructed by taking two half cells, namely zinc and copper half cell. So zinc half cell, which means a zinc electrode is in its solution of zinc sulfate, and copper half cell is nothing but the electrode copper which is immersed in its respective copper sulfate solution. Both the half cells are connected externally through a wire, and the two solutions are separated by a porous disc. So this is the simple construction of a galvanic cell, and by constructing so it operates. Here in these two electrodes, zinc and copper, the zinc electrode that act as anode and copper electrode act as cathode. See working of the galvanic cell. See here it is nothing but the working procedure of the galvanic cell. Here the zinc electrode is taken as a anode and copper is taken as a positive electrode, that is cathode. In general, anode means an electrode at which oxidation occurs, so it liberates electrons to the external circuit. So zinc act as a anode, and from the anode material electrons are liberated to the circuit. And copper act as a cathode at which reduction process occurs, that means it receives electrons from the circuit. And both of the electrodes are immersed in their respective salt solutions, so the electron flow that takes place, and Y means chemical energy that converts into electrical energy. Now come to the galvanic cell reactions. So while writing galvanic cell reactions, we must represent anode and cathode. Here the anode is zinc. At anode, oxidation occurs. Oxidation means liberating of electrons to the circuit. So zinc that liberate electrons. So zinc gives rise to zinc 2 plus 2 electrons. And cathode, he is nothing but the copper here. At cathode, reduction process occurs, is nothing but acquiring electrons from the circuit. So here the copper that receives electrons from the circuit and forms a copper. If we add both the reactions, we get a net reaction. In the net reaction, the zinc plus the copper ions give rise to zinc ions and copper. So here is nothing but the total net reaction of the galvanic cell. So in the galvanic cell, we are using two electrodes, zinc and copper. By means so, it performs the conversion of chemical energy into electrical energy. So this is the cell reaction. Now come to the comparison of electrochemical cell and electrolytic cell. First part, come to the electrolytic cell. So in the electrolytic cell, what is the energy conversion of electrolytic cell? Whatever the electrolytic cell, it should convert the electrical energy into chemical energy always. So the energy conversion of electrolytic cell is always electrical energy into chemical energy. And the transfer of electrons of this electrode here is different in electrolytic cell when compared to electrochemical cell. In electrolytic cells, the anode is treated as a positive electrode, cathode is treated as a negative electrode. See, anode is a positively charged electrode, cathode is a negatively charged electrode. So this is in the case of electrolytic cell only. The working principle of electrolytic cell is the conversion of electrical energy into chemical energy. So in this, input is electrical energy, output is chemical energy. In this electrolytic cell, positive electrode is anode, negative electrode is cathode. Here the transfer of electrons is from anode to cathode, but the charges are opposite when compared to electrochemical cell. Now come to the chemical cell, is nothing but electrochemical cell. So in this energy conversion, as we known already, that is a chemical energy into electrical energy. So chemical energy is input and output is electrical energy. And in this transfer of electrons is always from anode to cathode, Here the anode is a negative electrode and cathode is a positive electrode. See, it is a basic comparison of both kinds of cells like electrolytic and electrochemical. So students, please don't get confused. Here in the electrolytic cell and electrochemical cell that perform individually. So here the energy conversion is taking place in different manners. So whenever electrical energy is being converted to chemical, the cell is called electrolytic, and wherever the chemical energy get converted to electrical, the cell is operate like electrochemical cell. So these are about the comparison of electrolytic cell and electrochemical cell. So thank you. If you have any doubts, please contact